to your guys' announcements that you hear every morning. But from now on, we're trying something a little bit differently. So every Friday, get ready to see a broadcast of your guys' announcements. Students, as a friendly reminder, food deliveries and drop-offs to the front office are not permitted. Please remember that items dropped off during the day must be limited to urgent items only. To all my fellow seniors, if you still haven't checked out the Cajon website to order your cap and gown or sign the senior contract, you still have time. There are links that are very easy to access, but if you have any further questions, you can see Mrs. Heather in the front office. Cowboys, there's actually a new club on campus. If you want to play paintball but don't know anybody to go with, join the paintball club. They have meetings every Wednesday near room C13 after school. Alright Cowboys, the countdown before the end of the semester has now begun. There's only 19 days of school left, and our goal within that time is for you to take pride in your work. And the only way to do that is to have great attendance, have the right attitude, and a laser-like focus on your academics. So starting today, let's try to get on time to all of your classes, Cowboys.
Seniors, we have a virtual presentation of UCLA at 3 p.m. on November 18th. You can sign up with Mr. Yu in C35 during lunch or after school. Please see Mr. Yu for more information.
Hi, Cowboys. My name is Natalie Salcido. I am the president of the Cajon High School Students for Change Club. And I'm inviting you guys today to come join our club. We do a lot of civic engagement work. So we meet with our principals, our vice principals, to do a lot of work around mental health and also voter engagement. And we also meet with a lot of school board members and state legislators. So if you are interested in joining our club, feel free to follow our Instagram account. We usually meet every 2 weeks on Monday at 5 p.m. As of right now, our meetings are on Google Meets, but that is subject to change. So if you're interested in joining, we would love to have you guys there. And so don't forget to follow the Instagram account. Thank you. We're inviting you guys to come every other Wednesday to come and learn about French culture, French food. We have a lot of fun activities planned and fundraisers planned. We're looking forward to seeing you.
This is John talking about the new projects of the DC Extended Universe and what's to come next down the line. So up first, we got The Batman with Robert Pattinson, which is set to be rated R and 3 hours long, coming out on March 4th of next year. Next off, we have DC League of Super Pets, who has Dwayne The Rock Johnson and Kevin Hart playing two dogs apparently. Next up, we got Black Adam with Dwayne The Rock Johnson again playing Black Adam, which is set to come out this July. And rounding up the end of next year is The Flash with Michael Keaton and Ezra Miller pretty much playing Batman and Flash, coming out next year.
Alright, what is your name?
My name is Alexander Mario.
Okay, and you were a former wrestler?
Yes,
Cajon
I am.
High School.
Yes.
Okay. So, is it still too late to join the Cajon wrestling team?
No. You do need to catch up because, you know, they do have a very intense training schedule, but I'm pretty sure you still be able to join.
Okay. And how would you do that?
So, of course, you need to get your athletic clearance done, you know, via the website, and then you're going to have to turn in your physical. And then after that, just message the coach about when the times are, and he'll get you in.
Okay. What are the times for the wrestling and, like, the schedule?
So, it really depends. When we go to weight room, we usually do it from 4:30 to 5:30. And after that, we either go home or we stay from 5:30 to around 7 o'clock for our actual training.
Okay. Is there any diets or food you should stay away from when you're in wrestling?
So I did not get that far into wrestling to the point where they did tell me to watch my diet. But they did say that a lot of vitamin C and D was important. Mm-hmm. And you do have to watch your diet because, of course, it is a very physical sport. So just lay off the sugars, I think.
Okay.
That's probably my best advice.
And I've heard a rumor from having different body types, it could be an advantage or disadvantage. Like, let's say you might be scrawny, but very, you know, lean, very, you know, like, tight. So you can kind of, like, maneuver well. Or you can either just be too big. Would that be an advantage or disadvantage?
You know, that really does depend, because I am a pretty... I was a very big dude. Mm-hmm. Bigger than usual in wrestling, so I did have the disadvantage of shooting. Oh. Which is basically just, kind of trying to pin them down by... Well, it's hard to explain, but I was just not good at shooting, necessarily, because of my height. You know, that's usually what smaller people do. But for me, I think my best, my strong suit was probably grappling. Since I think my size allowed for me to have a lot of strength.
So, like, kind of, like, towering over your opponent, like, you know, going over them and kind of keeping them down.
I was really excited.
You think that's, like, what makes or breaks a lot of people in the sport?
Oh, definitely, because if you watch the fights, number one, like, they get packed. There was a lot of people there watching. And sometimes that anxiety turns into adrenaline, and they'll rush you, like, the first round of the fight. And that sometimes messes you up, because since you're letting your adrenaline take over, yeah. You get gassed, you get tired, and you mess up a lot. You look like a basic street fighter.
Yeah.
If you let the adrenaline take over.
Yeah. So, probably like second and last question, or probably the last one, but like, how do you feel now about it? Like, I want to talk about overall progress. Like,
about my fight or about training?
Well, like, just your experience overall, you know, with the training, and just your fight, like, after all that training.
So, in the beginning, training, because I used to be really, really overweight. Yeah. I was, like, 230 pounds. Like, I was really overweight. So, in the beginning, it was definitely a struggle having to build up my endurance and start to cut weight for the fight, because there's no way I could have fought on 230.
Yeah.
So, at first, it was a real struggle, mentally and physically, because you want to quit. Like, you really want to give up sometimes. They go hard. And you kind of have to get rid of that mental block that's telling you you can't do it and just push through. You just got to do it. And I feel like the training I did definitely did get put out in the fight. Like, my technique was clean. Everything I did was clean. We had to go extra rounds, mm-hmm. just because we were going so head-to-head. And, like, what was really cool about it that I found out is the guy I fight, well, he was a legit fighter. He competes with adults. His uncle is some, like, Muay Thai MMA champion. So, like, I was fighting a legit fighter. And the fact that I was able to go so head-to-head that they had to put extra rounds was, like, amazing to me. Like, it showed me, like I'm in this legit. Like, I fight this legit. So, after the fight, I lost, sadly. I lost by 1 point because they deducted me. It was a struggle at first, because I had worked so hard for something and I had to lose so much weight and go through, like, a really big mental block just to lose. It sucked at first. I left the ring and, like, I really had to have a discussion with myself. But the day after, like, it kind of felt like I just needed to go harder. It was a lot more motivation. Oh. Definitely. Like, I feel like I needed that loss, yeah. to be better. I needed to lose in order to win the next one. Mm-hmm. So, honestly, like, it was a really good experience. It was really good.